Yep.
Hi, I'm Billy. Today we're going to go through the basic steps of throwing a football. If you watch me, you'll be the best passer in the world.
The passer demonstrates proper hand placement. Generally, it's best to have fingers at least somewhat on the laces. Grip placement will differ between individuals due to hand sizes as well as hand flexibility. The general rule, though, is that you want your index finger to leave the ball last in order to add more spiral. Today we've broken down the football throw for you into 16 easy steps. Doing this helps to make it a little more digestible and easy to understand. So Billy is going to go ahead and demonstrate the first step, which has no environmental manipulation and no intertrial variability. The second phase that he will be demonstrating is environmental manipulation with no intertrial variability. He's going to go ahead and stand in one place and demonstrate the four-phase throw. Next, Bill demonstrate no environmental manipulation and no intertrial variability. He's going to demonstrate a five-step drop as well as a rollout without the ball. This is to get him to get a feel for what he's going to actually be doing, and then later on we'll add in object manipulation. The next stage, Billy will be manipulating the environment, but there's once again no intertrial variability. Next, Billy will be demonstrating no environmental manipulation, but there is intertrial variability. What he's demonstrating is the different types of arm movements, while also consciously thinking about the different types of hand grips that may result from a bad snap or that sort of thing. Next, Billy will be doing the same thing, this time with the object in hand. Now Billy's actions begin to get a little bit more complex as he practices a drop as well as a rollout with the follow through, but no object. Now there's object manipulation as well as intertrial variability. Now Billy's practicing no environmental manipulation. He's in motion, but there's no intertrial variability. Billy now completes the same exercise, except this time with object manipulation. In the next phase, there's no environmental manipulation. Is in motion, there's no intertrial variability. The last phase introduces environmental manipulation. He's in motion, but there's once again no intertrial variability. In the last phase, there's no environmental manipulation. The subject is in motion and there is intertrial variability. In this phase, Billy's going to stand in various positions around the field to simulate different throwing situations, while also practicing the fourth phase throw to a moving receiver and with no object manipulation. In the next phase, there is environmental manipulation. The subject is in motion. There's intertrial variability.
Restart that.
In the next phase, there's environmental manipulation. The subject's in motion. There's intertrial variability. In the next phase, there's no environmental manipulation. The subject's in motion, and there is intertrial variability. This is very useful in developing the mental aspect of the passage game. The final phase represents the most complete and game realistic scenario. There's environmental manipulation, the subject's in motion, there's also intertrial variability.
Seems my life is gonna change. I close my eyes, begin to pray. Then tears of joy stream down my face. We're long as well.
Now we'll go ahead and demonstrate differences, individual differences between throwing. Differences in height, weight, size, arm flexibility, arm strength, hand placement.